Está bueno. No sé en
Hay
qué.
bastantes palabras que pues todavía me cuestan ver, pero ahí me
Pero le
rebusco y
entendés.
en el instante ahí lo traduzco. Sí, lo entiendo bastante. Ahí
Vaya,
pues
no, amigo.
me pude desenvolver ahí hablando con él.
No, está bien, me llega. Igual tengo una alumna también. Ella es del grupo de los martes, miércoles, jueves, que ella quedó en call center. Yo la mandé, o sea, ella sí, y quedó en Concentrix. Ahí está en una cuenta de chat ahorita la cipota. La verdad que me alegró, pues, aunque ella ya va a nivel, ya casi 9. Ella lleva a nivel casi 9 ya. Entonces la cipota ya se defiende
Algún día
bastante.
llegaremos a esos
No,
niveles.
la
Algún
verdad
día,
que,
primero Dios.
no, hombre, cómo
Fíjese
no,
de que
ellos.
yo estoy platicando con él y él me estaba contando sobre la cultura gringa.
Ajá.
Y le habíamos en el viaje a la playa y le dije, ¿cómo tú dices? Buen provecho. Y me dice, pues, en realidad nosotros no lo decimos. Me dice. Solo
Sí.
comemos y ya. Pero
Y
de ahí
de...
me se puso a pensar y dice, bueno, cuando tú vas a un restaurante, las camareras dicen, enjoy your meal.
Ajá, enjoy your meal. Y de hecho hay el auxiliar do, ellos casi no lo utilizan, fíjate. Por ejemplo, nosotros les decimos, do you like to play? Ellos solamente dicen, hey, let's go play. O hey, let's play to basketball, for example. O sea, ellos casi no utilizan los auxiliares, de un solo hablan. En cambio, uno como uno, pues si está aprendiendo inglés, uno le enseña en este caso al alumno que tiene que hablarlo pues correctamente, vea, correctamente. Lo que tienen los gringos... O sea, en este caso, perdón, perdón, tenía que apagado. Lo que tienen en este caso los gringos es que ellos se avientan a hablar inglés como caiga. Ellos no les da pena eso en este caso. Quiero que me confirmen si en algún momento llegan a escuchar que el internet me falla, me avisan para cambiarme de servidor, ¿ok? Hola,
Okay.
Marce. ¿Qué tal? ¿Cómo estamos, Marce? No te había saludado. Estamos aprovechando que habían ingresado pocos. No sé si venís manejando. Hello, hello, Marce. Ahí estamos.
Hola.
¿Qué
No, no
tal?
tengo carro.
Ah, sí,
Tengo
es
que manejar.
cierto, vea.
Pero algún
Es,
día
no,
le
vea,
diré que sí.
primero Dios, ya muy pronto, pero ya mejor de salud.
Sí, gracias a Dios, sí. Ya,
Vaya,
al
ok.
menos ya medio camino más.
Va, excelente. Igual repitiendo, porfa, si de repente escuchan la señal o algo, me avisan, porque sí, todavía Tigo sigue ahí de con la señal un poco mala. No es mi casa. En general, me están diciendo mis vecinos que sí, Tigo está fallando. Ok,
Va a la
chicos.
colonia.
Ay, sí, hombre, cabal. Pero bueno.
Uy, es lo
Bueno,
que hay.
ni modo. Pero aquí tengo listo el otro servidor por cualquier cosa. Ok,
Okay.
students, voy a aprovechar que solo tengo tres, que ya voy a ver qué le ha pasado a los demás,
Sí.
ya los voy a regañar. Como les digo, es primera vez que me pasa esto, but we are going to start with a simple question in English. And the question is, what were you doing on weekend? Well, in my case, I was doing many things. It was a full weekend for me. Number one, on Saturday I was celebrating. Si usted se fija, la pregunta está en pasado continuous y mi respuesta es en pasado continuous también. So, I was celebrating Father's Day. I know it isn't the day today, but we were celebrating Father's Day. So, we were visiting a restaurant at the beach. The name of the restaurant is Beto's. It's a really nice restaurant. Well, actually, it's one of my favorite because I like seafood. That was for lunch. In the afternoon, we were visiting my family in Sonsonate because I have family in Sonsonate. And we were having a cup of coffee. We were enjoying with my family. On Sunday, I was a very full Sunday. It was a very busy Sunday. And in the morning, I was having breakfast with my best friends. And at lunch, I was preparing the lunch for my family. And in the afternoon, I was visiting the National Park in San Salvador because I like to walk. So I'm going to start with the only man. In your opinion, Christian, can you please tell us what were you doing on weekend?
Oh, I very, very busy on my weekend. On
Ajá.
Saturday, my family and I visited in the morning el hospital.
Okay.
And we're practice hiking. We were walking on the route, sorry, in the way for the mountain, and we have lunch. We ate chicken and soup in the night. My cousins and I, we were dancing in circus bar.
Hey, but that is true? It is a
yeah,
true
it's
story.
True. It's true.
Hey, can you tell me how was the experience in that place?
In circo.
It is a good place to visit.
Yes, no, it's complicated because this night the bar had very people. Many people, and the waiters are late with your drinks or
with the
food.
Orders.
Yeah, with the orders. Yeah.
So do you recommend
but the music
is nice.
Nice, yes. And
but I think it's just reggaeton music, right?
What?
Reggaeton music.
Electronic music. Yeah.
Ah, okay.
It's very, how do you say, variado? It's random.
Variety. Oh, yes.
It's random. But yeah, reggaeton is.
How much is it? How does it cost?
It's high. Well, many things. I don't know. A pizza costs $10 or $15, and the
per person
bottle of vodka
is personal. The pizza is personal.
No. 8 pieces
to share.
Yeah.
Okay. Yes. Christian, do you dance in the bar?
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
Can you dance?
Yeah, I was dancing.
can you believe it, Karina?
What?
Can you believe it? Karina, do you think Christian is a good dancer?
Yes, I think.
Yeah, of course.
Okay. But yeah. What kind of music can you dance, Christian? Everything or
everything?
Reggaeton chuco.
Reggaeton
chuco on the floor? On the floor?
Yeah, on the floor. Yeah.
Hey Marce, what about you? Can you dance?
Yes, I can.
Okay. So, but how often do you go to a discotheque?
The last time I went to the discotheque in 1999.
It's like a,
no.
For example, 2019.
Yes, 2019. Yes.
Ay, en 1999. Pucha, ya tiene rato. Okay. 2019. Okay.
Yes.
So, now, would you like to go to the disco?
Yes, but for the pandemic, I don't.
It's dangerous.
Go. Yes, I don't go.
Okay, yes, I share the same opinion. So, Karina, what about you? Do you agree with Marcela's opinions about the pandemic? Would you like to go to the disco now in the pandemic time?
I want es para pasado, ¿verdad?
Yo, pero ¿qué quisieras decir?
Yo fui.
I went,
sorry.
No, sí, pues sí, perdió el viernes, hija, se le olvidó todo. Continue, please.
I went to the disco in the last year in the pandemic.
How was the security? You had to use a mask, alcohol gel.
Yes, but the discotheque, it's a, my friends, bueno, tengo, mis amigos son dueños de esa disco.
Ah, okay, so repeat after me, my friends.
My friends
are the owners.
Are the
owners.
Owners.
Ya te voy a mandar ahí la palabra.
Okay. And,
propietarios, owners. My friends owners. Are the owners.
My friends okay. Are mm-hmm. Owners. Yes.
Okay, and so.
Yes, ah. I using the mask.
Ah, okay.
And alcohol gel, yeah.
And the alcohol. Christian, what about the security? Talking about the pandemic way. You have to use the a mask, alcohol gel.
Where?
In the circo bar.
Circo bar, okay. The security, how do you say, medir?
The measures?
The measures of the temperature of the people and put alcohol uh-huh. in their hands.
Hey, I have a question. Yeah. The people, excuse me, were the people using a mask during they were dancing?
No, mask really? Off.
Oh, really? And what about yeah. you?
Mask off too.
Okay.
Well, yeah, because eating or drinking mm-hmm. and dancing. Oh, yeah. I was with my mask off.
Okay. Yeah. Okay, nice. Thank you so much. Welcome, okay. Genesis. How was your dog? Is he okay?
Yes, teacher, he's okay.
So what does the doctor said? ¿Qué dijo el doctor? What's that the doctor said?
It's a little, how do you say infection?
It's an infection?
It's a little infection.
Ah, okay, but is he okay now?
Yes, he's okay.
Okay, I'm so happy to listen to you. Okay, nice, thank you. Kayla, hello, welcome.
Good evening.
How do you feel? What about the temperature? Are you okay?
I'm bad.
Okay, but I have a question. Would you like to participate, Kayla, or just listen?
Just listen, teacher.
Okay, okay, it's okay for me. But if you want to participate, let me know, okay?
Okay.
Okay, thank you so much. So, teacher. Okay, you're welcome. Repitiendo, si escuchan que de repente me escucho trabada, los salvadoreños, me avisan para cambiarme de servidor. Okay, chicos, we are going to continue with the topic. In this case, we have 1, 2, 3, 4 dialogues. Then number 1 is at the dinner, number 2 at the movie theater, number 3 at the class reunion, and number 4 in the mountain. In this case, the topic is in present perfect. Si usted se fija, la conversación está en el tiempo presente perfecto. ¿Cuál es el presente perfecto? Cuando tengo el verbo, el auxiliar have o has, y el siguiente verbo lo tengo en past participle. Utilizamos el presente perfecto cuando decimos yo tuve que estudiar, yo tuve que cocinar, yo tuve que hacer alguna actividad. So, in this case, can you please, Genesis, turn on your audio? Karina, please turn on your audio. Ladies, you are going to read the 4 conversation. So, in this case, Genesis, for the dialogue number 1 at the dinner, you are going to be Rachel. Karina, for the dialogue number 1, you are going to be Ian. Okay, ladies, 3, 2, go.
I hear Kate plans to quit her job next month.
Really? How long has she worked there?
She has worked there for 5 years.
That's a very long time. Why does she want to quit?
She can't stand her new manager.
Okay.
Sigo con el dos.
Yes, please. In this case, dialogue number two, Karina, you are going to be Brandon. And Genesis, you are going to be Finn. Thank you.
Okay. Where is Marlena? The movie is about to start.
Yeah. How long have we waited for her?
We have waited for her for 40 minutes. It feels like 40 hours.
Let me give her a call. Taylor, is that you? I have seen you for a long time.
Hello, Dina. What a small world.
I know. How long has it been since we graduated?
We graduated high school in 2006, so it has been over 10 years since we last met.
No, I feel super old, but it's good to see you. We shall catch up.
It feels so good to go hiking in the morning. I haven't gone hiking for a long time.
I agree. The air is so fresh.
I'm getting hungry. How long have we been here?
Me too. We have been here since 7 a.m. My stomach is so grumbling.
Y grumbling, cuando te está rugiendo el estómago de hambre, grumbling.
Stomach is so grumbling.
What? It has been 4 hours since we came here. Let's go grab a bite.
Okay, I have a question for you, Karina. Y Genesis se prepara con la misma pregunta. Karina, when you read a conversation in English, obviously in English, what is the most difficult part? The pronunciation or to understand the reading?
The pronunciation.
Okay, why?
Because that words, it's difficult.
Okay, thank you so much. Genesis, in your opinion, when you read in English, what is the most difficult? To pronounce or to understand the reading?
For me too, the pronounce, because sentences, I don't understand too much sometimes.
And what about this reading? Do you understand the four readings?
So.
Okay, excellent. Thank you so much. Let's go. I'm going to continue with, let's see. Can you please, Marcela, turn on your audio? Christian, turn on your audio. The same dynamic. Yes. De una lectura se van pasando a la otra. Okay, lo misma dinámica.
Okay.
Dialogue number one. In this case, Marce, you are going to be Rachel. And Christian, you are going to be Ian. Okay, guys, please go.
I hear Kate plans to quit her job next month.
Really? How long has she worked there?
She has worked there for 5 years.
That's a very long time. Why does she want to quit?
She can't stand her new manager.
Where is Marlena? The movie is about to start.
Yeah, how long have we waited for her?
We have waited for her for 40 minutes. It feels like 40 hours.
Let me give her a call.
Supongo que es Argentina. Tú habla.
Taylor,
okay. Is that me siento pura alumna, hablando y con el micrófono. Yes, please, continue. Yes, continue. Thank you.
Okay. Taylor, is that you? I haven't seen you for a long time.
Hello, Dina. What a small world.
I know. How long has it been since we graduated?
We graduated high school in 2006. So it has been over 10 years since we last met.
Now I feel super old, but it's good to see you. We should catch up.
It feels so good to go hiking in the morning. I haven't gone hiking for a long time.
I agree. The air is so fresh.
I'm getting hungry. How long have we been here?
Me too. We have been here since 7 a.m. My stomach is grumbling.
What? It has been 4 hours since we came here. Let's go grab a bite.
Okay, excellent. Thank you. So, the same question. Marce, when you read in English, what is the most difficult? To understand or to pronounce the words?
It's more difficult to pronounce because I me trabo en algunas palabras.
I have problems
with that pronunciation of the word.
Okay, in this case, Marce, we have 1, 2, 3, 4 readings, 4 conversations, 4 different topics. Do you understand all the readings?
Yes, but the dialogue 3 is very confused for the beginning. But after I understood.
Okay, and what about you, Christian? What is the most difficult? To understand or to pronounce?
In my opinion, teacher, understand some words because I don't understand many, vocabulary. I need to learn more vocabulary for understand some words, but I understand some words, and I how do you say dar sentido?
It's sense. Cuando tiene sentido, it's sense.
Yeah.
Cuando algo no and tiene sentido, it isn't sense.
And I try to sense.
Okay. O por ejemplo, teacher, yo trato de hacerme la idea. I try to figure out.
I try to figure out the sentences.
Okay, you try to figure out what the reading is about. Okay, thank you so much. I'm going to continue with the brothers. Mr. Venturas, hello, welcome to your English class. How are you?
Hello, I'm good.
Excellent. And you, how are you? Jonathan, right? Or Jeremy? Who was Jonathan, right? I was confused with the microphone.
Yo respondí, Jeremy. Jeremy.
And what about you, Jonathan? How you doing? ¿Cómo has estado?
Yeah.
How was your week, Jonathan? Good, nice, excellent, so-so, boring, stressful.
¿Cómo sería la anterior week? La anterior.
The last week.
No, bueno. The last week.
Normal?
No sé. No, excellent, digo yo.
Excellent. Ah, okay. What were you doing?
Because.
¿A dónde anduviste? What were you doing?
Ay, pero es que no sé cómo sería. We have been training for selection.
Yes, I remember that. Excellent. Okay. And you, Jeremy, how was your weekend? How was your Saturday and your Sunday?
¿Cómo puedo decir cansado?
Tired. Yes, cansado. Tired.
Tired.
Yeah.
Tired.
Tired, stressful.
I was training at Pesabol with Fred, with no sé cómo decir with preselection.
With the preselections.
Yeah.
Ah, okay. So how many hours were you training with your brother? How many hours? Around.
Normally 2 hours or 4.
Ah, okay. Okay, that is nice. Well, in this case, you and your brother are going to read the 4 dialogues. So, for the dialogue number 1, Jeremy, you are going to be Rachel, and Jonathan, you are going to be Ian. I'm going to make sure your pronunciation, okay? Thank you, brothers. Can you please, 3, 2, go.
Okay, I heard Kate plans to quit her job next month.
Really? How long has she worked there?
She has worked there for 5 years.
That's a very long time. Why does she want to quit?
She can't stand here, new manager.
Okay. Where is Marlena? The movie is about to start.
Yeah, how long have we waited for her?
We have waited for her 5 minutes. It feels like 40 hours.
Let me give her here a call.
Okay. Taylor, is that you? I haven't seen you for a long time.
Hello, Dina. What a small world.
I know. How long is that? How long has it been since we graduated?
We graduated high school in
2006.
2006.
Yes.
In 2006. So it has been over 10 years since we last met.
Now, I feel super old, but it's good to see you. We shall catch up.
It feels so good to go hiking in the morning. I haven't gone hiking for a long time.
I agree. The air is so fresh.
I'm getting hungry. How long have we been here?
Me too. We have been here since 7 a.m. My stomach is grumbling.
What? It has been 4 hours since we came here. Let's go grab a bite.
A bite. Hey, hoy sentí que iban leyendo así como que bien, como que no se sentían seguros. ¿Qué pasó? ¿Sentían que el vocabulario era un poco difícil o cómo? Porque sentí así como que A, E, I. Ajá.
Sí, era como esas como palabras I haven't seen, no sé, o I haven't gone.
Este es el presente perfecto. Ajá, este tema lo vimos, si no me equivoco, el día viernes, el presente perfecto. Igual, ya vamos a hacer un pequeño ahí repaso. Ahora bien, the same question, I'm going to start with Jonathan. Jonathan, when you read in English, what is the most difficult, to understand or to pronounce the words?
Digamos que
the most difficult to read, excuse me, to pronounce or to understand.
No sé, las dos cosas.
Both significa ambas. Okay, both. Okay. In this case,
yeah both, because when I hear people speak English,
You get confused.
I get confused. Y más si es americano, ¿verdad?
And also, because, if an American person.
Yeah, because their English is very fast.
Yes, it's the same. For example, when you speak Spanish in front of American people, maybe they can say the same. They have the maybe they have the same opinion. We as Salvadorians, I think we talk very fast in this case. So it is the same. But in this case, maybe you have to practice. But talking about Jonathan, the four readings, reading 1, 2, 3, and 4, do you understand all the text or not?
I think había una que no me acuerdo cuál era, pero creo que
2, 3, or 4. At the dinner, at the movie theater, at the class reunion, or in the mountains.
Yo perdí. Ah, esta, la primera, había una palabra que no sabía cuál era.
Dialogue number one. Or this one, dialogue number 4, because I think this word, grumbling, esa como que de las cuatro lecturas, creo que esa fue la palabra más, así que, teacher, no sabía yo que era grumbling. Grumbling, so, por ejemplo, my stomach is grumbling, está rugiendo. O sea, grumbling es cuando tu estómago está rugiendo de hambre.
Y también están, que no sé qué es eso.
Which one?
1, 2, 3, or 4? 1.
She can't stand her new manager. Stand. Ella no puede quedarse. Stand. O stand. También tiene el significado cuando la gente te dice, hey, stand up. Ponete de pie. Stand up. Okay. Thank you so much. Nice. Thank you so much, Jonathan. Jeremy, in your opinion, talking about reading, when you read in English, obviously in English, so, what is the most difficult, to understand or to pronounce?
I think understand, because I need a lot of words or verbs.
Okay, nice. Thank you so much. Okay, el presente perfecto. Yo creo que solo ustedes dos creo que no estuvieron el viernes. El presente perfecto es esto. Quiero que, por favor, Jonathan, me ayudas a leer la primera oración.
Okay. How long have you studied English?
El presente perfecto es esto, mira, Jonathan. Cuando tengo la base have y el siguiente verbo cae en past participle. Eso lo estuvimos incluso creo que viendo desde el lunes, si no me acuerdo. Ahora bien, how long have you studied? ¿Desde hace cuánto tiempo has tenido que estudiar inglés? So, I'm going to continue with these questions because I want to discuss the questions with you. So, can you please, Jasmine, welcome to your English class. Can you please turn on your audio? Welcome. Hi, hello, teacher. How are you?
I'm fine, teacher. Thank you.
Excellent. So, Jasmine,
today I'm going
in
my office.
Oh, okay. Are you in your office right now?
No, right now in my house.
Okay. But you were working in your office.
Yes.
Okay. So, no, this is a very simple dynamic. Can you please help me to read again, otra vez? Question number one. Quiero que se preparen porque aquí vamos a hablar todos. Question one, please.
How long have you studied English?
How long have you studied English? Thank you. Solo en la pregunta uno les puse el ejemplo de cómo se contesta en el presente perfecto. Si usted se fija, mantengo la base del verbo have. Have. I have been. Yo he estado estudiando. Ahora bien, yo puedo decir también, I have studied. Yo he tenido que estudiar. Entonces, yo lo quise hacer con este caso, con el verbo to be, utilizando el past participle, para no confundirlos y para que usted diga, teacher, ¿de qué está hablando? Es como que yo conteste, I have been studied, yo he tenido que estar estudiando, I have been studying for 6 months. O en este caso, yo he tenido que estudiar. I have been studied. Utilizo los mismos verbos. Mire, have and studied. Y aquí solo le agregué el complemento. ¿Cuánto tiempo has tenido que estudiar inglés? I have studied for 6 months. Vaya preparando sus respuestas, Karina. Can you please help me to read question number 2? Thank you.
How long have you had a cell phone?
Okay, ¿desde hace cuánto tienes un celular? I have had. Si solo digo I have a cell phone, estoy diciendo simple y sencillamente yo tengo un celular. Pero en este caso, yo tengo un celular desde hace. Entonces, I have had a cell phone. In my case, since 2008. Un ejemplo estoy dando. En mi caso es del 2008. I have had my first cell phone since. Esa palabra since significa desde. So, I have my cell phone since 2008. So, I think 10 or 12 years ago. Can you please, Christian, question number 3? Just read, please.
Yes. How long have you had an email address?
¿Desde hace cuánto tienes un correo electrónico? Well, in my opinion, I have had an email since I was 20 years old. Desde que tengo 20 años de edad. Ahí cambié el complemento. Ya no dije, desde el 2008, sino que dije, no, desde que tengo 20 años de edad he tenido un correo electrónico. I have had an email address since I was 20 years old. Desde que yo tenía 20 años de edad. Can you please, Jeremy, next question number 4.
How long have you been a student? Had a job.
Teacher, pero yo todavía soy estudiante, yo no tengo un trabajo. O lo opuesto, teacher, pero yo ya no soy estudiante, ahora ya trabajo. Entonces usted va a contestar de acuerdo a usted. Teacher, pero yo soy ambos porque soy estudiante en la academia y trabajo. Entonces contesta de las dos maneras. In my case, ¿desde hace cuánto, en este caso, desde hace cuánto eres un estudiante? O, ¿desde hace cuánto tienes un empleo? How long have you been a student? O, how long have you had a job? In my case, I have had a job since 2001. My first job, mi primer trabajo, my first job was at the age of 15. Mi primer trabajo fue a la edad de los 15. Estoy inventando en este caso. My first job was at the age of 15. Thank you. Can you please, Marce, next question.
How long have you been married or single?
Antes de continuar, ¿hay alguien que esté casado aquí? 5, 4, 3, 2, o casada, 2, 1. Ok, entonces, a todo mundo le vamos a hacer la pregunta.
Yo.
Sí,
con mi soledad.
Ay, Dios guarde, dijo, lloremos.
El otro año invitándonos a la boda, ya va a ver.
El otro, no, mira, tuve una corazonada, al rato se nos casa, Cristian, vos.
Va, yo le hago Christian. El pastel.
Ahí está, ¿ve?
No, hombre, ahí está. Esos males no me los deseen.
No, ya dijiste. Ya dijiste, Cristian, no, ya dijiste. Vaya, ok, para mí todos son single ahorita, felizmente single. So, how long have you been single? ¿Desde hace cuánto estás single, soltero o soltera? Como la canción, vea. How long have you been single? Well, in my personal opinion, teacher, I have been single for 5 years ago. Desde hace 5 años. I have been single for 10 years ago. I have been single for 2 years ago. I have been single for all my life. Teacher, toda mi vida he estado soltero. Toda mi vida he estado soltera. I have been single for all my life. Continue. Can you please? Next. Let's see. Uy, ya iba a decir Keila, y Keila, Keila no puede participar. Uy, Karina, please.
Me,
okay, okay.
Thank que you, le dé la Cari primero.
Okay, thank you. How long?
How long have you lived in your house, apartment?
¿Desde hace cuánto vives en esa casa o en ese apartamento? Es lo mismo, contesto fácil. I have lived in my house for 20 years, teacher. For 20 years ago. Teacher, I have lived in my house since I grew up. Desde que crecí. Since I grew up. Teacher, I have lived in my house since 2000. Desde el 2000, teacher. Next, Christian, please. How long?
Yes. How long have you lived in this country?
¿Desde hace cuánto vives en este país? Yo creo que todos vamos a contestar. I have lived in this country since I grew up. Grow up. Crecer. O sea, yo vivo aquí desde que nací. So, I have lived here since I grew up. O sea, desde que crecí, teacher, desde chiquito he vivido toda mi vida aquí. Can you please, Genesis, next. How long?
How long have do you know me?
No, this one. How long have you lived in this city?
I live in this city.
No, can you? No, just read the question, please.
Sorry, I don't understand. How long have do you live in this city?
Okay, ¿desde hace cuánto vives en esta ciudad? I have lived in this city since 2001. Desde el 2001 vivo en esa ciudad, teacher. He tenido que vivir desde el 2001 en esa ciudad. For example, I have lived in San Salvador. I have lived in Santa Ana. I have lived in Santa Tecla since 2005, teacher. Okay, next. Can you please, Jeremy, the next one.
How long have you known me?
¿Desde hace cuánto me conoces? Well, I have known you. El verbo está en past participle. I have known you 4 months ago. Desde hace 4 meses. I have known you 1 year ago. Desde hace un año. I have known you 6 months ago. Desde hace 6 meses. Thank you. Can you please, Jonathan, the next one?
How long have you known how to use a computer?
¿Desde hace cuánto sabes usar una computadora? Okay, teacher, in my case, I have known how to use a computer since when I was starting high school. Desde que yo estuve estudiando bachillerato. I have known you how to use a computer 5 years ago, desde hace 5 años. It's just an example. And the last one, Marce, please.
How long have you liked your favorite TV show?
Okay, en esta pregunta la mayoría vamos a inventar, porque yo sé que ahora con Netflix ya como que los programas específicos favoritos ya no existen. Ahora la gente solo habla de Netflix. Entonces aquí en este caso vamos a inventar. ¿Desde hace cuánto te gusta ese programa? So, I have liked this program 6 years ago. I like this program because it's about comedy, and I like comedy TV shows, for example. Okay, I'm going to make pairs because I want to listen you in pairs according to having a normal conversation. The dynamic is this one. Por ejemplo, si hacemos parejas, en este caso supongo que fuera Genesis con Jonathan. Genesis pregunta, hace la pregunta número 1, la responde y luego Jonathan hace la misma pregunta a Genesis para que la respondan. Vamos respondiendo la misma pregunta. Ok, I need 2 volunteers, please. Volunteer number 1.
Me.
Thank you, Genesis. And volunteer number 2. Just 1, thank you.
Me.
Okay, thank you, Marcela. Okay. In this case, Genesis, you are going to read question number one, and then, Marcela, you are going to read the question again to Genesis. But, teacher, ¿y todas las vamos a leer? No, esa es otra cosa porque si no el tiempo se me va a ir aquí. Chicas, solamente escojan, en este caso, cuatro preguntas. En este caso, Genesis, tú escoges dos, las que tú quieras para Marce, y Marcela, tú escoges dos, las que tú quieras para Genesis. No sé si me doy a entender. ¿Yes? Or no?
Yes, teacher.
Okay, I'm going to start with you, Genesis. Yes, please. Question number one for Marcela.
How long have you studied English?
I have been studying English for 4 years and 4 months.
Question for Genesis.
Okay.
If you want, you can. If you want, you can ask the same one, or you can change the question.
Okay. And how long have you had a cell phone?
I have a cell phone.
I have had
a cell phone for 2019.
Okay, question for Marce.
How long have you been a job?
I have job in 2020. And how long have you lived in this city?
I have lived in this city since I grew up. How long you know how to use a computer?
Computer?
Computer.
I have known how to use a computer since when I was 13 years old.
Okay, and the last one for Genesis, thank you.
And how long have you had an email address?
I have an email address since 2015.
Okay, ladies, thank you so much. Genesis, choose one student, please, except Kayla. A excepción de Kayla, porque Kayla está solo de oyente ahorita.
Mi teacher.
Karina Gay. Ah,
ok. Ah,
ok. Wow.
Volunteers.
Oh, yes, of course. Ok. Yeah, with the ladies first. Mary, please, one question for Christian.
Ok. How long have you had an email address?
Ok, ok. Wait. I had an email when I was 12 years old. Escojo ahora yo una, ¿verdad?
Yes, please, choose one.
How long have you been had a job?
I have been 2012. Así es, ¿verdad, teacher?
Yes, okay.
How long have you lived in this country?
Okay. I have lived in this country since I grew up. How long have you lived in your house?
I have lived. ¿Cuál es?
La última de la columna de la izquierda.
Ah, okay. I have lived in my house since 4 months.
Okay. Next.
How long have you liked your favorite TV show?
I have...
I have like...
I have... Sorry, thank you. I have like my favorite TV shows since...
Things,
Don't know. 2020.
Okay, and the last one, please, for Genesis. Excuse me, for Karina. I was reading the name. That's what I was confused that. Okay, for Karina.
How long have you had a cell phone?
I have had a cell phone since 2010.
Okay, excellent. Thank you so much. Can you please, Christian, choose one student? I'm going to help you. I got Jeremy, Jonathan, or Jasmine?
Jeremy.
Jeremy, thank you. And you, Karin?
Jasmine.
Thank you. Nice elections. Okay. Jeremy, are you ready? Jasmine, are you ready too?
Yes.
Yes.
Excellent. Okay, the same dynamic. Choose questions for Jeremy. Thank you, Jasmine. Question number one.
Okay, Jeremy, how long have you know how to use a computer?
I have known.
Uh-huh.
How to use a computer since 10 years ago.
Okay. Question for Jasmine.
Okay. How long have you lived in this city?
I have lived in this city since 2012.
Okay.
Yeah.
Question for Jasmine.
Le pregunto yo ahora a ella.
Yes, please.
How long have you studied English?
Okay. I have studied English in 3 months, actually.
3 months ago. Hace 3 meses. Okay. Uh-huh. Yes, the last one for Jeremy, please. The last one, right?
How long have you had a cell phone?
I have.
No. Huh? Okay. Yes, continue. What's your turn, Jasmine? The last question for Jonathan. Yes, you.
It's for me?
Yeah, it's your turn. Okay, yes. Okay. Choose one for Jonathan.
Okay. I have a cell phone.
I have had
a cell phone. I don't know, 3 years ago.
3 years ago. Okay. And now the mm-hmm. last one for Jonathan.
Okay. How long have you lived in your house?
I was confused, like Jeremy. No, don't worry, Jonathan. I said Jeremy.
Sorry.
The question is for Jeremy.
¿Cuál era la, for Jeremy. La pregunta?
Yes. Repeat it, Jasmine. No sé si se confundió Jasmine o yo. Okay.
Yo me confundí.
One more time.
Sorry.
Entonces
ya no pregunto yo, ¿verdad?
Como no, please, the last one for Jeremy, thank you.
Okay, Jeremy, How long have you known me?
Ya le va a pegar. How long have you known? Okay. How long have you known, Jasmine?
Respondo yo ahora, sí va.
Please.
I have known you since, I don't know, 4 months ago, I think.
Okay. I think it's one, but okay.
Thank you.
Okay. Thank you so much. Now, Jonathan, no te has salvado todavía. Termino contigo. Señores, preparen una pregunta para Jonathan. Can you please, Marcela, choose one question for Jonathan. Thank you. Sí, con una pregunta también.
Aparte de las que están ahí.
No. The same, please. Choose one.
How long have you liked your favorite TV show?
¿Desde hace cuánto te gusta hacer ese programa? You have to invent.
Okay. I have liked this show since 2 years ago.
Okay, thank you, Genesis. Question for Jonathan, please. De ahí me ayuda Karina, porfa.
How long have you had a cell phone?
I have had a cell phone when I was a child.
A child,
yeah.
Okay, excellent. Muy bien. Cari, your question, please be ready. Christian, thank you.
How long have you been married or single?
I have been single? Yeah.
Uh-huh.
I have been single since... 6 months ago.
Okay. Yeah. The last one, please.
How long have you been a student or had a job?
I have been a student the last year. Yeah.
¿Desde cuándo sos estudiante? Desde que naciste, en
este
caso.
Sí.
Entonces, so, I... have been a student.
I have been a student.
15 years ago, desde hace 15 años. 15 years ago.
Yeah.
Okay, nice, excellent. So please, student, nos ubicamos en esta página. Esto es un ejercicio bien fácil. Ubiquémonos, por favor, les doy 5 segundos. Les mentiría si les digo en qué página está, pero ahí está en el folleto. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. This is a very simple exercise. We have to match the questions A to G with the answers from 1 to 7. So I'm going to read the questions, and please, students, you are going to give to your teacher the answer. Letter A, where is my pen? The correct answer, number 7. I don't know. I haven't. Siempre tenemos el presente perfecto. I haven't seen it. Letter B. Why are you looking so pleased with yourself? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, or 6. Why are you looking so pleased with yourself?
Number 3.
Let's see. Are you sure?
No.
Okay, perfect. Okay. ¿Por qué te miras tan contento? Básicamente es la pregunta. Why are you looking so pleased with yourself?
Number two.
Oh, let's see. I passed all my exams. Porque pasé todos mis exámenes. Esa palabra pleased. Es un adjetivo también. Yes, excuse me.
No, iba a preguntar que si era un phrasal verb.
No, es, no. En este caso es como un adjetivo, o sea, cuando, cuando tu rostro refleja que andas contento.
Porque no, no dice happy.
Ajá, pero es un sinónimo, es un sinónimo. Okay. Entonces, en este caso, pleased, se oye como que ella hace un favor, ¿verdad? Pero en este caso, pleased, está, si se fijan, está como que el verbo en pasado. Entonces, el pleased viene siendo como que, o sea, se te ve looking, ¿eh? Se te ve que andas así como que contento contigo mismo. ¿Qué pasó? I have passed all my exams. Letter C. How is the math going? Hey, ¿cómo usted está yendo en matemática? How is the math going?
Five.
Five.
Number five. Not very well. It's got much more difficult this term. Excellent. Letter D. Why are you buying a new mobile? Number three, let's see. Yes, because someone, porque alguien has stolen, presente perfecto, has stolen my old one. ¿Sabían ustedes que se puede decir cell phone o también se puede decir móvil? Cualquiera de esas dos formas. Móvil o cell phone. Exacto.
¿Verdad que en Estados Unidos le dicen móvil y, en Inglaterra le dicen mobile?
Así es. Y de hecho, fíjate de que nosotros los latinos decimos cell phone, vea. Pero en realidad es poca las personas que usan la palabra móvil. Móvil. Letter E. It is sunny outside.
Number one.
No. It start to rain. Excellent. F. Why are you looking so fed up? Ahí sí tenemos un phrasal verb. What are you looking so fed up?
For.
Let's see. I have a really bad day. Una manera de decir enojado. Bueno, no hay, hay varias maneras de decir enojado o molesto. Angry. Mad. And fed up. Hay otra también, angry, upset. Esa también la upset también, para decir que estás molesto, enojado. Angry es la base, enojado, angry. Pero de ahí molesto, furioso, entonces fed up, upset o mad. Ok, letter G. Where is Jeremy?
In his house.
In his house. Yes, but this is another one. This is another one. Where is Jeremy?
Number six.
Jonathan.
Okay. También. Okay. Okay. Hey, haven't you heard? No, no has escuchado. He's had an accident. Estamos hablando de otro Jeremy, vea. Oh. Él tuvo un accidente. He's had an accident.
Be careful, Jeremy.
Yes, be careful. Take care, please. He's in the hospital. Okay. Hey, easy, right? This exercise, I think, is easy. Very easy for you, or not?
Yeah.
Yes or not? Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, perfect. Vamos con algo que me encanta. Observe la palabra, perdón, observe la pregunta que está en azul. What's the reading about? Obviamente, antes de salirse de la clase, me tiene que decir de qué trata la lectura. Si usted se fija, la lectura está en presente perfecto, porque todos están utilizando el verbo have, y el siguiente verbo está en presente perfecto. Ok, como ustedes son nivel 4, yo no necesito leerles la lectura porque yo sé que ustedes manejan una buena pronunciación. Lo que vamos a hacer es la misma dinámica. Voy a comenzar a leer la lectura yo y de ahí voy a escoger otra persona, hago pausa, la otra persona sigue, hago pausa, la otra persona continúa, etcétera, etcétera, etcétera. So, the topic is the old colonel. Hey, teacher, o sea que si yo le digo, what's the reading about? Y si yo le digo, the reading is about a man, ¿ya me puedo salir? No, tampoco, vea. Me tiene que decir de qué trata la lectura, si le gustó, si no le gustó, etcétera. Ok, the old colonel. Reading comprehension. I'm going to start with Genesis. I think.
Sorry, teacher. I'm 18.
Okay,
I think I have had a very interesting life. I am 73 now. 73 now and I don't work anymore.
Stop. Christian, continue.
Yes, I was in the army for 51 years. I retired when I was 69.
Stop, Jeremy, continue.
I have been to so many countries that I can't remember all of them. I've been to Australia 6 or 7 times and to South Africa 3 times.
Stop, Jonathan.
I have also been once to Russia, but I didn't like it at all. Much too cold for me.
Thank you, Karina. They say
that love is the greatest thing, and I agree. I've been married 4 times, but never for more than 5 years. I don't think women really understand me.
Thank you, Marcela. Continue, please.
I've never been on television, but I've been on the radio once. It was a program about life in the military about 20 years ago.
Thank you, Jasmine. I met the Prime Minister
on the same day. Actually, I have met a lot of people, members of the royal family, famous politicians, and also famous cinema and television personalities.
Thank you, Christian.
Yes. Sorry, me perdí.
Ya está. Ya hablas igual que Marcelo. Gracias, teacher. Marcelo,
bien coqueto. Hey, hoy no está, Marcelo.
No, hoy no está. Oh. Es que supuestamente dije que está ocupado el muchacho, vea. Ok. Viendo continuo, Cristian. I never met.
¿Dónde, teacher? Perdón, que me hablaba.
This one. I've never met the American.
Oh, yeah. Okay, thank you. I've never met the American president. Talk, which is a pity. Because I've traveled a lot, I've seen a lot of wonderful things and have also eaten and drunk some strange foods or drinks.
Stop, thank you. Can you please, Kari, finish?
I ate cats and rats in India and drank something called Mirtu on a little island in Italy many years ago.
Le voy a demostrar que toda la lectura usted la ha entendido. A excepción de Keila, porque está enfermita. De ahí todos activen mi micrófono. La persona que no me active el micrófono, solo a él le voy a poner a traducir. Yo voy a leer en inglés y al mismo tiempo quiero que en coro me vayan traduciendo en español. Ok. Dice, yo creo, I think.
Yo creo.
Yo creo.
Ajá, continuo.
Que yo he tenido una vida muy interesante.
Yo tengo.
¿Cuántos años tengo?
Y ahora yo no trabajo.
Stop. Muy bien. Y ahora ya no trabajo. Yo estuve a donde.
En el ejército por 51 años.
¿Por cuánto? Y me retiré
cuando yo
tenía 69.
¿A dónde estás?
En muchos países.
Pero ahorita no recuerdo. No recuerdo.
Ajá. Muy bien. Stop. Voy solo con las niñas. Caballeros, me apaguen el micrófono, al menos que usted vea. Yo respeto, si quiere, tenga un entendido, pero voy con las señoritas. Señoritas, ¿a dónde ha estado?
He tenido que estar en Australia.
¿Cuántas veces? ¿Y a dónde más?
En África del Sur.
¿Cuántas veces?
En Rusia.
No.
Y también en
Rusia, pero no gusta,
¿qué pasó en Rusia?
Porque
hace
mucho
frío.
Porque hace mucho frío para él.
Ajá, mucho frío para él. Caballeros, señoritas, apaguemos micrófonos. ¿Qué dice ¿Qué dice el coronel según lo que dicen las personas? They say,
ellos dicen que
el ellos amor, dicen que el amor es
la es? Mayor cosa.
Era,
la mayor,
mayor, mayor cosa y yo estoy,
estoy de acuerdo.
Ajá. ¿Él ha estado
qué? He estado casado cuatro veces.
Pero
nunca por más de 5 años.
Por más de 5. ¿Por qué?
Yo no pienso.
¿Qué piensa él? No,
que las mujeres
lo entiendan.
¿Qué problema es? Que dice que las mujeres no lo entienden. Señorita, voy con ustedes. Yo nunca
veo la televisión, pero sí es.
Ojo, stop. Yo nunca he visto o yo nunca he estado.
Nunca he estado.
¿Nunca he estado? ¿A dónde?
En televisión.
Pero
sí he estado en la radio una vez.
¿Cuántas veces?
Una.
Ajá. ¿Y de qué era el programa?
El programa
es acerca de la
vida militar. Los militares, más de 20 años.
¿Hace cuántos años
hace
fue eso?
20, hace 20 años. 20 años.
¿Y a quién conoció?
Al primer ministro.
¿Cuándo?
El mismo día.
El mismo día.
Ajá. Caballeros, actualmente, ¿qué pasó?
Actualmente, yo conocí
a mucha gente famosa.
Por ejemplo,
miembros de la familia real.
Ajá. ¿Qué más?
Políticos famosos.
Ajá. Y también
famosos del cine y televisión.
Personalidades de la televisión.
Ajá. Stop. Señoritas, ¿a quién nunca? ¿Qué pasó?
Nunca conoció al presidente.
¿A quién?
Al presidente.
Nunca conoció al presidente.
Era muy...
So which is a pity. Esta es una expresión, lo cual es una lástima.
Sí, es lástima.
Pity, sí, pero es como una lástima vos. Hey, it's a pity. Ay, no es como que yo le sienta lástima a una persona. Ahí sí es muy distinto. Aquí es cuando yo digo, hey, qué lástima que no fuimos allá, vea. O sea, es una expresión bien informal. Pity. Lo cual es una pity. Lo cual es una...
Lástima.
Caballeros. Lástima. Because...
Porque
que
yo
he viajado mucho
y he visto cosas maravillosas.
¿Y que también?
Y que también comido y bebido
comidas extrañas y bebidas.
Ok, stop. Con, por ejemplo, señoritas.
He bebido en una pequeña isla en Italia.
¿Hace cuántos años?
Hace muchos años atrás.
Muy bien.
Gatos y ratones.
Sí, guácala. Y esa arquitectura es real, supuestamente.
Conozco personas que han comido perros.
Ay, no, cállate, hija.
Bueno, los que van al estadio, ¿verdad? Bueno,
la verdad que sí. Ok, the last dynamic, señores. Volunteer, what's the reading about? When you answer the question, you can leave the class.
Me, Christian.
Yes, Christian. Your opinion, what's the reading about?
In my opinion, teacher, the reading is about a person. He has 73 years.
He was
a military man, and he traveled around the world, and he met very famous people, including famous politicians and famous cinema and television personalities.
Stop. Thank you so much, Christian. Nice participation as usual. See you next Friday.
Thank you, teacher. Good night. See you on Friday.
Thank you. Next.
Yo, Jeremy.
Volunteer. Okay, Jeremy number one. Jasmine number two. Okay, Jeremy, go.
Okay, I think it's a very, very good history about this man. Uh-huh. And he is a very interesting person because he traveled around the world a lot, and he ate a lot of things like cats, rats, and he drank a lot drinks like
Mirto.
Like Mirto, huh? And on a little Iceland.
Island.
In Italy, island. Ah, yeah. On a little island. And he met a lot famous person like royal family, famous politician, and famous.
Stop. The last question, Jeremy. Do you like the reading?
Yes.
Why?
Because I think, or I need a more pronunciation like fluency, or como digo, tener menos nervios para leer o algo así.
To have less nervous, or to be less nervous, tener menos nervios o estar menos nervioso. O don't be nervous, no ponerme nervioso.
Don't be nervous
when I read.
Okay. Don't be nervous when I read.
Okay, that's it. Thank you. See you next Friday, Jonathan. Thank you. Okay,
yeah, Jeremy. Yeah, yeah.
Okay, Jeremy. Okay.
Y que tiene la misma voz.
Eso, y su mamá porque les puso, no, y también les puso el mismo nombre con J. ¿Por qué hizo eso su mamá? Ok, Marce, sí, no, ok. Sé. So, Jasmine, number one. Jonathan, number two. Marcela, number three. Porque Jasmine ya me levantó la mano. Ok, good night,
ya puedo
Jeremy.
Salir, teacher.
Yes, of course, yes, you can.
Ok, bye, buenas noches.
Ok, bye, thank you. Jasmine, go.
Okay, teacher. I think the history is about the man. It's a complicated life because in is your life in the army. I think so. He married four times, but never for 5 years. It's for your life, yeah. It is a I don't know, valiente. Se me ha ido la palabra.
It's strong.
It's a man.
Brave.
Brave.
Valiente is brave. Brave. Un hombre fuerte, strong.
Brave and strong. Ha vivido mucho, I don't know.
He lived a lot.
What do you say?
He lived a lot.
He lived a lot.
Okay.
Only?
Okay, but the question, do you like the reading? Do you like the reading?
Yes, I like.
Okay, why?
If it, in my case,
it's an interesting reading or what?
No, it's an reading. It's good for me.
Okay.
Para aumentar mi vocabulario.
To improve, mejorar. To improve my vocabulary or to learn, aprender. To learn new vocabulary. To learn new vocabulary. No sé si mi internet estuvo fallando un ratito, Jasmine, porque creo que había cosas que no me entendía, ¿verdad?
Sí, yes.
Okay, I'm so sorry, but it's my internet. Okay, thank you so much, Jasmine.
Thank you.
Okay,
bye.
Good night. Thank you.
Good night.
Okay. Jonathan, are you ready?
Yes, I'm ready.
Ok, ojo, teacher, pero a Cristian no le preguntó nada. Sí, lo que pasa es que Cristian habló bastante tiempo y en ningún momento tuvo ningún problema de vocabulario. Entonces, si yo le hago una pregunta a ustedes para que practiquen más, ok, no es porque, ay, me equivoqué, entonces no es para que practiquen más. Okay. Yes, Jonathan, what's the reading about? Se prepara Marcelo.
Ok, the reading is about a man that he has had a very interesting life, and he thinks that the woman do not understand, and he is a retired when was 69 years old, and he's traveled a lot. He's seen a lot of wonderful things, and ate and drinks strangers. He ate stranger food and drinks. And he met a lot of famous persons.
Okay. Yes. Perfect. Excellent. Thank you.
Okay.
See you next Friday.
Okay. Gracias, teacher.
Okay. You're welcome. Bye. Genesis, are you ready? Or Karina?
Karina.
Yes, teacher.
Okay. Who the wants to be? Genesis. Okay. Thank you so much. Okay, Genesis. Yes, please.
Teacher, perdón. Y no iba Marcela.
Oh, my goodness. I'm so sorry, Marcela. Yes, please go.
Okay,
go, Marce.
The reading is about a colonel. He had an interesting life. He is 73 years old, and he met a very countries because he was in the army for 51 years old, and he had four wives, and he was on television. No, he never was on television, but he was on the radio. He talks about the life in the military experience, and he knows many people famous, for example, the royal family, famous of the cinema, and politicians, but never knows the president of the American. And he ate very
disgusting food.
Disgusting food for, and I think it's the typical food for countries.
That. From China, for Asian countries.
Yes, okay. For Asian countries. And that's
thank
all.
You so much, Marce. Thank you. See you next Friday. And I'm so sorry, I was confused, okay?
No se preocupe. No,
okay, thank viernes. You so much. See you. Bye. Okay, Genesis, go.
The history is about an old colonel. He think had a very interesting life. He don't work anymore. He visit so many countries. He visit Australia 6 or 7 times, and he the same visit South Africa 3 times. He don't like visit Russia because it's too much cold for him. He think the love is a great thing. He married 4 times, but never for more than 5 years. He think the woman really don't understand. He meet a famous people. He meet a famous politicians. He meet a television personalities, famous cinema, and members of the royal family. He never meet an American president. He seen wonderful things around the world, and have so eaten and drunk some strange foods and drinks. He ate disgusting food for me in India, and he drank something called Mirto in a little island in Italy so many years ago.
Excellent. Wow, nice. Thank you so much, Genesis. See you next Friday. Take care of your dog, okay?
Good night, teacher.
Good night. Okay, Kari, I'm going to finish with you.
Okay, the history is about the military man. He traveled for many countries, for example, Australia or South Africa. And he doesn't like Russia because it's very cold. He say the love is great, and he teacher me quitó la.
Oh my goodness, I'm so sorry.
Estaba guiando.
I'm so sorry. I'm so okay, yes, continue please.
Okay.
Quería apagar el micrófono y le di dejar de compartir. Okay.
Okay. He thinks the woman really understand, and he never been on television. And he meets famous persons, for example, members of the royal family, famous actors, and political people.
Politicians,
Politician people, but
he never met
the president.
Okay, which is a pity, lo cual es una lástima. Okay.
That's it.
Yes, perfect. That's it.
Okay.
Que ocupaste una técnica bien chiva porque pasaste la lectura a hablar como en una tercera persona. Él piensa esto, él piensa lo otro. Esa es una técnica bastante buena cuando nosotros queremos.
Sentí que se me hizo más fácil.
Ajá. Si te fijaste, lo único que hiciste fue cambiar la persona. En ese caso, pasaste la lectura a hablar de una tercera persona. A él le gusta esto, él hizo él, y está excelente esta técnica. Okay, muy bien, Kari, nos vemos el viernes.
Bye, good night, teacher.
Bye, good night, thank you.